Right. Let's get drawing. I hope you're all ready with your piece of paper and your pencil. So we are going to start kind of in the middle with a slight curve using my arm there. Then we're going to come down to here and I'm repeating a slight curve. And then I'm coming to here and I'm repeating it again. So we have these three slightly curved lines. We are then going to come from under this one. We are doing a shape that curves slightly that way and slightly that way. Like that. And then we're going to curve down here. So this is straight now. And then we're going to curve as we get to the bottom here. Like that. And then the other one. Straight down. And curve as we get to the bottom. Sometimes I have to feel our way if it doesn't feel quite right. We're also going to add a little bit, like a half line. I'm not going to join it all up. Sometimes we do part lines and the brain fills it all in. Now, let's go back to this one. We're going to come a little bit. In and out and up to about there. This is curved and another line about there. Now we're going to come to the middle. Not very happy with this shape. Feels a bit better. Trying to get it symmetrical is very difficult. So we're coming to the middle here. We're going to do a shape like that. I'm going to do a shape like that. We're going to shade that in nice and quickly. We're going to come under this one, curve line that way, up, and join into the hat. Just take that line up. Over this way, quite long, and that goes up and joins with the hat again. And another one just above, like that. We're then going to shade in quickly all of this bit. Nice and dark. Okay, now halfway along here, you're going to come up, over, back down. I'm going to do two little lines, just a little there. Now this one has got a nice curve to it, so it curves up and round, so like a sloping S-shape type, down, joins up. And we have another one, comes up, so we're still only kind of half of the flower. And on this side, I'm going to come up here, and around, I'm going to stop there. This one will come from the hat shape, curve over, touch that one, and then there's a little shape on the end coming back around to join. A little bit of a line on that one. And then we're over here. We're going to come quite long, and it goes down to a point, and back in. And we're going to do quite a light line down there, with a darker curved line there. Now, two more on this one. We have one like this, one like this. Now, this is all really light apart from this shape here, which is shaded in. Now we're going to come up here, in between these two. And then we have a shape that goes that way, into another hat. Shade that in. Catch up. Just trying to straighten my shape a bit. Now, we're then going to come out here. Join back. Now this one's tricky, so that line's easy there. We come back to this hat, we're going to come up, and then there's a point, a curve, and then another curve that joins there. Like that. And on this side, curve, join the hat. This one goes up, down, and then kind of goes back in and then back out again. And then there's a little shape at the back, just there. Shade it in a bit darker. I might make this a bit more pointy if I can. Now also, in between these two, We have a shape that comes out to a point, curves, and then comes back in. Right, we're coming back to this middle flower petal, coming to the next petal on the left, and then we're going to come up, shade that in, not as dark as these. These need to be really dark. And this is higher than this, so I need to make this a little bit longer. And then we're going to do another shape. Like a kind of heart diamond-y shape. So let's let you catch up. Now we've got another hat on here. Pointy. Shade all that in. And then we're going to come kind of slopes down, then up. And then a bit further up again, down, and then it joins, goes down and joins. We have a one that curves down, like a little one that's going over. See that shape? And then there, if we come to this point of the hat, there, then I'm coming right, and then we're going to go there, and I'm not going to do anything there, and you'll see why in a bit. Now, back to the hat, we're going to go out to the side, right, go down, and then join back to that. And we have one here, so this goes this angle and down, curves, comes up and joins with the hat. That fly is still hanging around. And then we have another one that comes from this one, joined. And curves there. Now we're coming back to this center one. We're coming at a slight angle, not straight, and we're joining up with this point of the petal. If yours doesn't join up, don't worry, no one will know. So we won't show the new picture. So this one is looking slightly from underneath. So there's some dark, kind of not really dark, but there's a shaded bit underneath that comes down. This bit's light into that kind of shape. This shaded bit then joins over here to the edge of here and then up slightly like that. It's hard to describe the shape. That makes sense. Like that. Now here, we have from the centre a curve that comes up down and joins. And we have another one that comes over to the right. And then on this side of that one, we have another one that comes up. Joins there. And then we have the hat on the top. Show that end off. Now we have another one that joins around to the back here. And then another one hidden behind, you just see an edge of it. And then one that curves down around there. Now we're coming back down to here, and we have a line that goes that way, out to this side. And on this one we have a curved shape. One curved shape, two curved shapes. And that then goes the other way, so it curves back to itself there. And then we have a hat. Hat's angled this way slightly. Let me shade that in. This one comes over this way. And we have another one, and this one actually touches this one. That then curves back the other way. This one curves down around here into a lovely shape, then comes back round towards there. Over this side, one that curves around, it's quite a thin one, joins here, then another one, joins here. One more at the back. There. Now we're just going to put in one more back here. So where the dark bit here was, we're going to come, it's a little bit dark there and there. And then there's another hat, and this hat's behind this line here. I'm going to shade that in. around here. Another one here joins up. Now we're going to do a darker line. I'm going to press a bit harder here. Now we're going to do some shading. So we're going to draw a straight line down here. And we're going to do this kind of mid-dark, so not really dark. We're going to do a dark shape like this. And that dark shape then curves to not to the edge, to here. Another one here. I'm going to leave kind of a gap here. I'm going to come over this way. Shade that in, shape there. Little line, shaded shape like that. And from this middle bit, join down here. I want a shape like that to start with, and then we've got some diagonal lines here, so let's get them in. 1, 2 And then that, there's another one here. 1, 2 There. This is all really light here. We're going to put a really dark bit there. There. And then very quickly, there's a lot more detail in here, but because we only have limited time, we're going to shade that in really quickly. So if I do it and then we can copy that shape. Something like that. And the same under here. It's like more lines like this down, which are the stems. And then we're going to actually just shade in this bit, either side of there. This is really light here. I'm going to shade in from behind it. So this bit, not as dark as this, but we want that to look lighter. So I could use big strokes just to hatch that in. There. And then on this side, go round and then curve down. And then here, shaded like this. some straight down shading here. Kind of curved shape there. And in between these lines we had there, we're going to use shading. There. Shading. There. And then some around this bottom here. So that actually, we could do a curve kind of shape there. And actually we'll shade that in, but not as dark as this, and this is then light. We need just a little bit more here. Shade all this in. There. Now, what I wanted to show you as well, if we have time, we could go a lot, if we had an hour, we could go a lot more detailed. But when you have, let me show you on this flower. This is a white flower with a black thingy. What we have got is an outline, which is fine, and that's the style. But sometimes what we want to do is actually get rid of the outline. And the reason that that is going to look white is by us doing some light shading behind it. So you could actually rub out your outline. If we do it really lightly, we don't need to. I've done it quite dark because you need to see. But what makes the flower light is the dark behind it. And you don't need to shade in the whole of something. You can just suggest. So let's come in here. We're not, you know, making a photograph. I'm kind of using sideways cross hatching. And then you can have that fading away. Fading away. That's really what you're trying to do, is show the difference of white on white. So white, a white object on a white paper. So you could kind of take your drawing back a little bit with your rubber and then, so it's called negative space really. So sometimes instead of drawing the positive petal or whatever the object is that's white, you're actually doing the background, and then that makes a positive shape stand out. And we've got time for a little bit more. So let's just do a little bit here. Shading, fading away, because you want it to kind of look like it's shading. So here, that it would be that bit. Now the other thing I want to just do is we're going to go darker down here, and we're going to put a shadow in here. So this is going to be dark. We're going to fade that off as well. You could do a little table if you want it to sit on a table. And we're just going to do a little line that's just hinting. See where that, this is the water line. And there's lots more we can do, but we've run out of time. So I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you've learned that you can take that off, and I will speak to you soon. Bye.